Hey guys, what is going on? It is Justin from Vonix Entertainment, and welcome to the Destiny 1 Zero Location video. Now, if you're looking for the Destiny 2 Zero Location video, I'll have a link down in the description below where you can go and check it out. But if you're here for the Destiny 1 Zero Location video, he is in the Reef, where I think he's going to be for the rest of the time. That Destiny 1 will be active somewhat. He'll probably stay in the Reef because he's been here for the past couple of weeks. For his legacy engram, he is selling leg armor. So if you're missing any leg pieces from year 1 or 2 that you want to get in year 3, remember this does not include the Warlock boots. So if you're looking for the Warlock boots, they will not pop up in this. For the Titan class, he's selling the Twilight Garrison. Now the Twilight Garrison is a great Titan exotic to have. If you don't already have it, you just press BB while airborne, and you can evade, and you can also select which direction you're going to evade by holding that direction whenever you're floating, and then pressing BB. For the Hunter class, he's selling the Capri Sting. Now, the Capri Sting is honestly a really fun one to use. It makes you invisible while crouching, and your invisible melee, if you hit them from behind, deals 4x damage. And melee attacks can cause lingering damage, such as like what the Thorn would do. Now, the reason I really like this is for playing Rift, because I don't have to use my crouch to go invisible for Rift, or I can use this on Gunslinger, or my Tether, just crouch and go invisible instead of having to throw a grenade, or not being able to go invisible at all. So it's really fun to do that. And then you can hide in the rift area, and sometimes people will just completely miss you. I've been surrounded by an enemy team entirely, and picked up the rift, and just ran and scored on them when they didn't even know I was there. For the Warlocks, he is selling the Nothing Manacles. Now, the Nothing Manacles, if you are a Voidwalker Warlock, and you like using your Shatter Grenade, your Scatter Grenade, then use this. This is a great, great gauntlet to have for you if you use that. What it does is it gives you an extra Scatter Grenade, as well as the Scatter Grenade also now has tracking. So if you hit someone or hit close to someone with your Scatter Grenade, it's going to track onto that person, making them pretty much die just by the grenade, because it does so much damage. And Xur's Weapon of the Week this week is the Last Word Hand Cannon. Now the Last Word Hand Cannon, if you don't have this, you really need to have it. It is a must in the Destiny 1 Crucible. And what it does is it can fire in full auto. It's really nice for that. And its perks are geared towards you firing it without aiming down the sights. That took me a while to get used to. But hip fire increases the accuracy while firing from the hip. And the Last Word proof perk, which improves your stability and target acquisition when firing from the hip. So you need to fire from the hip if you're going to use the Last Word. It's really, really nice. It's really stable. It's not going to go off their head that easily. It's such a nice one to use. And if you are a sniper person, my recommendation is have a sniper on your secondary. On your primary, have the Last Word. And so you can snipe someone from a distance, and if they get too close to you, say they're coming around a corner, switch to the Last Word and just fire into them, kill them, and then switch back to your sniper to go ahead and kill people from a distance again. And its perks that you can choose from are single point sling, high caliber rounds, and perfect balance. Now if I'm going to use this, I'm going to use the perfect balance. That way it doesn't go anywhere from that target. It's not going to move at all. So I highly recommend doing that. There's two Weapon of the Week this week, Weapon Bundles of the Week this week, are the Invective and Storm's Reproach, which kind of makes the Invective look like it has magma cracking through it, and the Nemesis Scar and Silver Bullet. Now, for both of these, remember, if you already have the exotic, go ahead and go to the Silver Dust Terminal, where you can pick up the ornament for 25 Silver Dust, instead of having to pay the 30 Strange Coins and the 25 Silver Dust. And Xur's two vehicle upgrades of the week are the Plasma Drive and the Void Drive. The Void Drive is kind of a rare one to see nowadays. But both of them are really nice. They're 23 strange coins each. If you just want to use it for aesthetic purposes, that's up to you. As well as also you can upgrade a blue sparrow into a legendary sparrow just by equipping it and then using one of these on it. They will upgrade it and you will have another sparrow to add to your collection. So thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like down below and comment on what you would like to see Xur sell next week. Remember, if you're looking for the Destiny 2 Xur location video, there is a link down in the description below. And I will talk to you guys, hopefully, a little bit later today, maybe even tomorrow for a stream. If not, there'll be another Xur video up next week. And I will see you guys there.